Hello, this is Echoing Clock.
And Ripper 95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902, and this is a cutscene.
Is it? Oh, it is.
That's a blue eco vent. More concentrated than the floating clusters. This vent will give you a full charge of blue eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
Now, if you saw our first episode, you'll know that blue eco is sort of explained quickly. Yes, it does open the door. I can jump in here.
No achievement jokes this time.
Yeah, no achievement jokes this time. As much fun as I had
spending hours
of my time
editing everything together, that was kind of funny, not gonna lie.
Yeah. I mean, I imagine I could edit an achievement right in there.
Those little green balls of energy on the ground are a type of eco. Pick up 50 small green ecos or one big green one to increase your health.
That was Ripper 95 banging his head against the desk because he doesn't like to hear Samus' voice.
Or the unskippable cutscenes. We know what this stuff does, Samus. Samus. However you pronounce your name. Samus Aran. And here's a new mechanic in the game that we're going to be introduced to a lot. Our blue eco platforms. You channel blue eco through your body, and then you jump onto that grass platform. It looks like
you need to be a little bit more energetic.
I'm sorry that I'm depressed that we got 4 hours into our let's play out of a 6 hour let's play, and we had to restart the whole thing, and we had to do it all in 10 minute increments.
Well, regardless, this is the blue portal. I imagine the orange portal is somewhere in Samos's house. So. In all honesty, I don't want to go back to the Green Sage's Head. I really don't like him. So you know what? I'm going to build a house right here.
Go Minecraft on this.
I was like, look at all this stone. I can
make so much cobblestone right
so
now.
So much cobblestone. I make a cobblestone furnace on that. I mean, there's a whole bunch of geysers. I imagine there's like some sort of lava pit under there somewhere. Like, just like get a bucket of lava.
Make some obsidian. Nether portal. All
right. If you don't understand the reference, we're referencing a game called Minecraft. It's by a group of Swedish developers. Pretty great game. So we're just gonna teleport over to the Green Sage's Hut.
Good training, boys. But that's nothing compared to the challenges that lie ahead.
And no problem. We got the moves, eh, Jack? We'd love to stay in chat, Big Green, but we're, itching to get on with our adventures.
Fine, fine. Adventure away, then. And while you're out adventuring, why don't you make yourself useful? My darn green eco-collectors are clogged up again. Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps. They'll take you right there. Now, all of you, get out of here!
So that was Samos the Sage explaining
what we should do.
What we should do. And you know
what? Oh, look, it's our boat.
Look at our boat.
Let's go ride our boat to Misty Island. Even though that's my least favorite area in this goddamn game.
Can we? I'm not sure if we could go to Misty Island.
Maybe we should go root out the fisherman. I heard he was in the jungle fishing by the lower river.
Why? It's our boat. We were just in this boat like 5 minutes ago on a cutscene.
Maybe he doesn't want us using our boat because of the lurker shark. He's afraid that we'll be eaten
the
by
the lurker shark.
The lurker shark. So you know what? Just to get the Samus the Sage off our case, I'm gonna go over to this place. I'm gonna do those green eco collector. His darn green eco collectors.
Which I always thought was dark, but that was kind of cool because you have to do kind of green eco. Nope, I'm just disappointed.
So in this place there's like new types of enemies. Because
no enemies.
There's no enemies in this. But you sort of saw the two enemies in the opening scene.
Yeah, the purple and the blue lurkers.
So these are lurker crabs. You can't punch them while they're in their shell.
Or else you just kind of look like an idiot.
Yeah, because they'll just spin off. These are lurker serpents.
We You never actually see their bottom half.
Yeah, you never do. You only see the top of their head when they pop out of sand. You can see a lurker seagull.
Is that a lurker seagull or is it just a normal seagull?
All right, more orbs.
Actually, that's a... Oh my god, I almost called it a pelipper.
A pelipper?
That's right,
everyone. This Pokemon is water and flying type, and that's our next Let's Play.
Let's play Pokemon Pelipper.
That's right. So, if I come up here, the first thing I see here...
That's 69 orbs. LOL.
LOL. So,
let's punch that bitch in the face.
So you know what?
Punch him in the face!
So if I punch the Pelipper in the
that
face...
That wasn't a punch, that was you just moving towards it suddenly. It flinched.
Quick! We have to get to the power cell before the Pelican scoops it up again!
We're both. So, yeah, congratulations. We officially suck at this game. Second episode and the fail train's already starting.
What, the fact that I had a bit of a delayed start?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's two power cells. And there's a puppy. Give me a hug! Oh, it hurt! That's what you get. Puppies don't like us. I guess the character Jack isn't an animal person, even though there's an ocelot on his back.
Which is what he is. Did they ever say that per se in the game?
I don't think they ever say that Daxter turned into an Oxhole, but that's what he is. He's like half otter, half weasel, sort of. And we really love puppies. It's just the puppies in this game are lurker puppies, and the lurker puppies sort of kill us. So yeah, these are green eco vents, kind of like the blue eco vents we saw back at Geyser Rock. Only they completely heal our health.
Even though later on in the game they'll give us green eco to spread around. Not really sure how science on that works.
And the last one had a power cell. Now it doesn't matter which order we get these in, the last one you do will always have the power cell in it. The same with the scout flies.
Which I kind of find stupid, but whatever. Well, now, a good way to sequence break the game is to jump up here, and that log you're supposed to punch from the bottom and lift it up.
This log right here.
Yeah. But I've always found it easier to just sequence break it like that.
Yeah. Now, and that was a crouch jump and a spin at the top, and that's how you do it. Now, you can't reach this like that. So, I'm sorry we're talking over Samus, but we don't like him. So, what I'm going to cover here, this is what the punch... You punch and jump, and that's what that kind of does.
Now, we just kind of talked over Daxter, but what he said, and it's actually a very useful feature in the game, is that you can trade orbs for power cells with villagers and people throughout the game, but even if you haven't spoken to somebody to do that yet, Daxter will always alert you to when you have the ability to. And it's normally always for 90, sometimes a little bit more in certain exceptions, because we'll see that in a minute. Now you might want to go back under ground there, because you're missing about 5 orbs.
As you can see, you could punch that back down with the ground stop.
Just so that, because we here at Echoing Clock Studios believe in putting away your toys when you're done playing with them.
Yes. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to come over here, climb up this, and there's orbs up there. That's 5 orbs. For those of you who can count, I'm sorry for insulting you. Alright. So we're going to come up here, and the last thing we're going to do this episode is get this
power cell.
And we're going to call that an episode. We'll see you next time, folks. This has been Echoing Clock.
And Ripper95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902.
Bye.